She served on the Armed Forces Service Committee and the House Science, Space, and Technology Committee. Something wonderful about Senator Rosen, that she was ranked as one of the most bipartisan freshman members of the House of Representatives in the 15th Congress. Thank you so much, Senator Rosen. Second in the Senate. Well, you'll be first very soon. Rosen received her undergraduate bachelor's degree from the University of Minnesota. She received another degree in computer science and information technology. What is so grand is she serves on the Committee on Health, Education, Labor, and Pensions. She serves on the Senate Committee on Commerce, Science, and Transportation, and on the Small Business and Entrepreneurship Committee. The Special Senate Committee on the Aging and Homeland Security and Government Affairs. We are so pleased that Senator Rosen joined the CEE board as an honorary trustee this year, and it's an honor to present Senator Jackie Rosen.
Everyone, I'm especially excited to be here because the young girl who started her career as a computer programmer couldn't have imagined the technology that we have today, and boy, have we come a long way, ways to go, but I want to thank you all for being here. I want to thank you for the wonderful introduction, and I noticed Senator Lieberman, Congressman Dunn, my friends here with us today. And so I really want to thank the Center for Excellence in Education. They support our students and they help them realize their full potential. The work your organization does each day is critical in creating the next generation of American scientists, engineers, inventors, and leaders. I'm proud to say that several Nevadans have been recognized by CEE with awards over the past several years, and I am very honored to be an honorary board member this year. Like I said, that young girl who started as a computer programmer is very honored today. And of course, across the country, we're seeing a huge demand for workers in STEM, with software developers, mathematicians, and health aides among the fastest growing occupations. A report came out just this past week that ranks Nevada as the fastest growing state for software jobs. The fastest growing state for software jobs. Go figure, maybe we'll outdo all those tourism jobs one day, right? But despite these increasing opportunities, we know that there aren't enough students out there who have the necessary STEM skills to work in these jobs. And it's organizations like CEE that are rising to meet the challenge by providing thousands of underserved students access to that very education. You are helping to close the gap in education and skills, and you're helping to build a workforce that is going to drive innovation for generations to come. Promoting opportunities in STEM education, like I said, it's a cause deeply personal to me because before I came to Congress, I was a computer programmer. And I know this is off script, but I programmed in those old languages like COBOL and Fortran and Assembler. And although my daughter does think I'm a dinosaur, I think those legacy, I like to call them a legacy language, and thank you very much. But it's an industry that's been long dominated, male dominated. It's changed some, but it hasn't changed enough, and it isn't always easy for us to break in and do what we need to do to succeed. And so some women have. These brilliant women, they're achieving at the very peaks of science, of technology, of software development, mathematics, and I'm incredibly proud of what all these new women are doing in tech and what they're accomplishing. And we know that women make up over half the workforce, but we only make up about a quarter of the the workforce in STEM. And that's what needs to change. The STEM gender disparity is holding us back. It's preventing talented minds from inventing the next breakthrough technology, founding the next big startup, and keeping our nation safe from cyber attacks. That's why I'm so passionate about giving women, particularly young girls, more opportunities to get involved in STEM in careers like coding and engineering. The most important investment that we can make in our country, in our future, is investment in our education and in those young minds that will make up the workforce of the future. And so that's why earlier this year I introduced my bipartisan building blocks of STEM. This legislation will help ensure that children are prepared with the education necessary to succeed in a 21st century economy, and is going to take steps to close that gender gap. This bill is going to direct the National Science Foundation to expand funding for early childhood STEM programs, and it's going to get fund grant programs for young girls interested in computer science. Because I know if we are going to lead the world in creating an economy of the future, we need all those young women, we need all our young minds, but we have to break through the barriers that leave people behind and help hold us back from reaching our full potential. And so, I am proud to say that my Building Blocks of STEM Act did pass the Senate Commerce Committee, and it is poised to pass the Senate fairly soon. And so it is just one step closer to becoming law. Because helping to build the people pipeline, it requires a well-trained and highly skilled workforce. Like I said, it's one of my very top priorities. Because by strengthening our education system and workforce development programs through STEM and other initiatives, we can ensure that future generations have access to 21st century education, and they're fully prepared to take on the challenges going forward this century. I can tell you, as an honorary board member and as a member of the Senate, I am committed to supporting programs like CEE and Congress, because I believe that quality education is truly the key to building a sustainable, successful economy. And so we are going to lead the way in doing that. And I want to thank you from the bottom of my heart and for all of those minds that you helped to stimulate for investing in education, investing in a platform for young folks and anyone who needs job retraining to build a success. And I wish you all the best, and onward and upward for future coders, scientists, engineers, technicians, whatever they are, with your help, we're going to lead the way. Thank you.